السلام عليكم وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. Are you hearing up? Ask them.
You hearing?
They are not hearing anything. More? Little more? Are you hearing? ما فيك خف من الله. هيدي. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Anyone likes to sit on the benches? Wants to sit? Can sit. Sure. You want to sit on the benches? بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. I feel when I going to say something that and from Grand Sheikh's teaching or Maulana Sheikh Nazim teaching, I feel that we are not some appropriate to speak because of our attachment to dunya. And you can see how they spend their lives, Allah making for them dunya slave to them because of their love to Allah and love to Prophet. But for us, we are not in that circle of lovers of Allah and Prophet. Might be imitational, yeah, we are trying, but real one, I don't feel that we are those people. And I will quote this hadith from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from Abi Rayhana, the companion of Prophet. He said that I heard Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, an Abi Rayhana sahibun nabiyyi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, an Abi Rayhana sahibun nabiyyi sallallahu alaihi wasallam qal, sami'tu rasulallahi sallallahu alaihi wasallam yaqul, la tara aynun an-nar, عين بكت من خشية الله. He said that I heard Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, and I will never see hellfire as long as that eye is crying and tears coming from khashyatullah. Khashya, from fear, is not fear, but it's awareness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or khashya is I feel someone to be unhappy with me. That's what it means. I do something, I know that someone is not happy with me, that's khashya. Akhsha, I feel not really doing what it needs to be done. So he said that Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لا ترى عين النار. An eye will not see hellfire as long as that eye has awareness and fear and feelings that Allah is not happy with it, so that eye is crying. Are we crying? Sahaba, when you used to mention if they were not able to see Prophet a day, they cry. Tears comes from their eyes. Pious people, if they were not able to see dreams or to fear Allah and love Prophet and love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they cry. Are we crying? No. So that shows us that we are not, because our attachment to dunya will not let you to be a servant to Allah. It wants you to be slave for her, for the dunya. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and that I will not see fire as long as وَلَا عَيْنٌ سَهَرَتْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, as long as that eye did not sleep in struggle for the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When someone feels that he is not struggling enough and preferring akhira on dunya, those pious people, they cry. We don't care. So that's why I was saying that when we feel and sitting and speaking, you feel that khashya, that fear of Allah, awareness of Allah is not there, because our involvement, only our thinking today, people, they think only today how much I am making, how much I have, how much I can make more. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for those who submit to Him, He made dunya slaves to them. Not we are slaves to dunya. And we mentioned many times that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam took his companions to Mountain Uhud, and it was sunrise. And he said, put the sun in your back, and what you are seeing in front of you is their shadow in front of them, because the sun in the back. And he said to them, anyone can catch his shadow, I give him my jubba. Run after it. They run. They were not able to catch their shadow. Can you catch your shadow? No. Until they reached the mountain, the shadow came on the mountain, and he said, stop. No one was able to catch the shadow. Then he said to them, look at me and run. When they looked at him, the sun was in front of them, the shadow was behind them. And they were running and came to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the shadow behind them running. He said, anyone turn his face toward me and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah made dunya slave to him, to run after him like the shadow running after you. But when you give me your back, you are giving Allah and to Allah and me your back, your dunya will be running away from you and you'll be running after dunya. Yeah. So that's why if a wali, if a saint give a speech, even he say assalamu alaikum, it is enough with the light that comes with it. It is enough for spreading heavenly light in your heart. But for us, when we say assalamu alaikum, it's empty. Nothing goes with it. So that's why to be connected with a guide that connects you with Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is important in the life of people, because it directs them toward awareness. And tonight is Laylatul Isra'i wal Mi'raj in many countries, and tomorrow is the night of Isra' and Mi'raj in other countries. So many countries around the world, they are observing it tonight, which is a night that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed His Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with it. And Allah praised himself by saying, سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنريه من آياتنا إنه هو السميع البصير. So this night, the night of the 27th of Rajab, it was the night of Monday. And that's why it is an important day. It was on a Monday, where Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born on a Monday. And he was being sent as a messenger for humanity on a Monday. And he was went into the journey of Isra and in Mi'raj, it is on a Monday. And he left Mecca toward Medina on Monday, entered Medina, reached Medina on a Monday, he died on a Monday. That's why the importance he is emphasizing, importance of a day. Because today they tell you, don't emphasize the importance of a day. No, there are days that they are important in the history of Muslims that we have to keep. That's why when he was asked about fasting the day of Monday, he said, this is the day that I was being born. Akhrajahu Muslim, that سئل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن صوم يوم الاثنين فقال هذا يوم ولدت فيه. He was asked about the fasting of the day of Monday. He said, yes, fast, this is the day I was born. He gave importance to the day that he was born. Importance of the day of 27 of Rajab, it's a Monday. He was born on a Monday, sent on a Monday, left Mecca on a Monday, reached Medina, entered Medina on a Monday, left Dunya on a Monday. And alhamdulillah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dressed us with the tajalli of this night, because that tajalli is a umumi, is a general manifestation on mu'mins and Muslims, the night of Isra and Mi'raj. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said that subhanahu alladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan min al-masjid al-haram, from praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he gave the journey for his prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, beginning it from Makkah, from al-masjid al-makki. And al-haram means Mecca, it's all haram. Haram means a place where you cannot commit a sin. So the Kaaba, all around the area is haram. Wherever you stand, the streets are haram. And where you cannot do anything wrong. In the interpretation of that, it is said that your heart is your haram. Everyone Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him a haram in himself that he cannot let shaitan to enter. Because in the heart there is a place where shaitan can enter. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, I am the only one that I have made my shaitan, I ride on my shaitan. Means everyone else is struggling in order that as to fight shaitan. And the best place is what Allah has left for you in your heart. As in Kaaba, there is the most important place. All Kaaba is important, but there is one place that people kiss, that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam qabbal al-hajar al-as'ad, he kissed the stone, the black stone. And they say the black stone originally was white from heavens, green white, and because of the sin of people that they are coming and touching, slowly it became darker and darker. It's carrying the heaviness of these millions and millions and millions of people that every year are going there and visiting Kaabatullah, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is said that the stone, the black stone, أخرج من الجنة وله ضوء فكل موضع بلغ ضوءه كان حرام. That black stone, when it was coming as descending from paradise, wherever there was a light coming from that black stone, as it is, that light, wherever it reaches, as it is coming down to Kaaba, wherever it reaches, that light become haram. That's why they say that Hudur al-Mashayikh, to be in the presence of a sheikh will give you a light, because that sheikh became a haram. Because he is filled up with the light from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As Sahaba, Prophet mentioned them, and when he, in the hadith where he said, Sahabati kan nujum, my companion like stars. بأيهم اقتديتم اهتديتم, anyone you follow you will be guided, because they become haram. Their presence with Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave them holiness, gave them something that been manifested on them from heavenly beautiful names and attributes. So they become different people, Sahaba. And Prophet ﷺ said, follow one of them, you will be guided, anyone you want to follow. Awliyaullah, Allah mentioned them. إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Nothing they have to fear, Allah will give them. So awliyaullah becomes like haram. When you approach them, as if you are sitting in a heavenly place, because they are not after dunya, they are after akhirah. Allah turned them away from, Allah turned shaitan away from them. وعن ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنه قال لما أهبط آدم إلى الأرض خر ساجدا. When Adam was being brought on earth from paradise, he went into sajda, asking Allah forgiveness. After 40 years in sajda, never raised his head. فأرسل الله تعالى جبريل بعد 40 سنة. After 40 years, he sent to him Jibreel. يُعْلِمُهُ بِقَبُولِ تَوْبَتِهِ, telling him that Allah accepted his repentance. فَشَكَى إِلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى مَا فَاتَهُ مِنَ الطَّوَافِ بِالْعَرْشِ. He complained and requested, Ya Rabbi, in paradise, I used to circumambulate around the throne, about the arsh. I have nothing here to circumambulate around. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from Baytul Ma'mur, from the fourth heaven, where is the original Kaaba, where all angels, all prophets, when prophets went into Mi'raj, he prayed imam in all prophets in Baytul Ma'mur, in the real heavenly Kaaba, Allah has descent a copy, not a copy, but a reflection of the Kaaba in paradise. He sent one to him on earth for Adam not to miss his tawaf in circumambulation around the throne. He gave him the Kaaba to make tawaf around Kaaba. And this is all to show how much Allah had gave Ummatul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and secrets in Surah Al-Isra, in the Surah of Isra. فَأَهْبَطَ اللَّهُ لَهُ الْبَيْتَ الْمَعْمُورُ وَكَانَ يَاقُوتَةٌ حَمْرَاءٌ. And it was that Kaaba that came, the reflection of it came on earth. It was a yakut, ruby, red ruby. Completely, which, how big is it? It was a ruby, red ruby. Has a red color coming, emitting from it. فَأَضَاءَ مَا بَيْنَ الْمَشْرِكِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ فَنَفَرَتْ مِنْ ذَلِكَ النُّورَ الْجِنُّ وَالشَّيَاطِينَ. And the light of that ruby has spread all over the earth. And shayateen and jinn, that they are not believers, they run away from it, from that light. Because that light, when hitting them, they are finished. فَفَزِعُوا وَتَفَرَّقُوا فِي الْجَوْءِ يَنْظُرُونَهُ فلما رأوه أي النور من جانب مكة أقبلوا يريدون الاقتراب إليه فأرسل الله تعالى ملائكته فقاموا حوالي الحرم في مكان الإعلام اليوم ومنعوهم فمن ثم تسمى الحرم بالحرم. When they run away, they run to above the earth and they were looking And when they tried to reach and they seeing that light coming, they tried to reach, Allah prevented them by angels. So that's will show us how much there are sacred and secret information that we ignore or we don't know, we are ignorant about it. These awliyaullah that had put tafsir of Holy Quran shows how much we are in need to learn and to give respect to the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned, that I am praising myself. Allah is saying that to bringing my servant in a mi'raj to be in my presence, it's not an easy, it is kun fayakun, but no one can do that. That's why Allah is saying subhanalladhi, means, oh human being, you cannot imagine that someone will go, I make someone to go to Kaaba Qawsayn aw Adna and come back in 2 hours and his mattress is still warm. And he visited 7 paradises, he checked hellfire, and Allah reduced the fire of hell, and he was in Kaaba Qawsayn aw Adna. No one was with him, even Jibreel alayhi salam was not able to be with him. So pious people, they consider that surah is meant them, because they understand that Al-Masjid Al-Haram is the maqam of Al-Qalb, is the level and the status of the heart, which is not allowed for the bad desires to overtake the heart. As you cannot do a sin in front of Kaaba, you cannot allow your heart to be affected with your bad desires. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to understand that our heart is a place which is sacred, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put light in that heart, as Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ما وسعتني سمائي ولا أرضي ولكن وسعني قلب عبدي المؤمن. Neither my heavens and my earth contained me, but the heart of the believer contained me. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our hearts a place where the manifestation of Allah's beautiful names and attributes reach there. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioning that He gave that journey at night from Masjid al-Haram ila al-Masjid al-Aqsa, the farthest place that you can reach to go and Prophet, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised Prophet from that place. They describe Masjid al-Aqsa as Maqam al-Ruh. So the level of Ruh is Masjid al-Aqsa. Anyone has to make Mi'raj, because everyone is eligible to follow the footsteps of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Prophet can take him in a Mi'raj up to the capacity of that person through his soul and through his heart. That's why everyone who speak in the language of spirituality define the soul, the importance of the soul, and define the importance of the heart. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to reach the heavenly beautiful names and attributes, knowledge, and be away from shaitan and be more nearer to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah forgive us. Bi hurmatil Habib, bi hurmatil Fatiha.